from around the globe. It's theCUBE, presenting Enterprise Digital Resilience on Hybrid and Multi-Cloud. Brought to you by IoTaho.
Okay, let's now get into the next segment where we'll explore data automation, but from the angle of digital resilience within an as-a-service consumption model. We're now joined by Yousef Khan, who heads data services for IoTaho, and Suresh Kaniappan, who's the vice president and head of US sales at Happiest Minds. Gents, welcome to the program. Great to have you on theCUBE.
Thank you, David.
Suresh, you guys talk about at Happiest Minds this notion of born digital, born agile. I like that, but talk about your mission at the company.
Sure. Founded in 2011, Happiest Minds is a born digital, born agile company. The reason is that we are focused on customers. Our customer-centric approach and delivering digital and seamless solutions have helped us be in the race along with the tier one providers. Our mission, happiest people, happiest customers, is focused to enable customer happiness through people happiness. We have been ranked among the top 25 IT services company in the Great Places to Work survey. Our Glassdoor ratings of 4.1 against the rating of 5 is among the top in the Indian IT services company. That shows the mission and the culture, what we have built on the values, right? This sharing, mindful, integrity, learning, and social responsibilities are the core values of our company. And that's where the entire culture of the company has been built.
That's great. It sounds like a happy place to be. Now, Yousef, you head up data services for IoTaho. We've talked in the past. You're out of London. What's your day-to-day focus with customers and partners? What are you focused on?
Well, David, my team work daily with customers and partners to help them better understand their data, improve their data quality, their data governance, and help them make that data more accessible in a self-service kind of way to the stakeholders within those businesses. And this is all a key part of digital resilience that we'll come on to talk about a bit later.
You're right. I mean, that self-service theme is something that we're going to really accelerate this decade, Yousef. And so, but I wonder, before we get into that, maybe you could talk about the nature of the partnership with Happiest Minds. You know, why do you guys choose to work closely together?
Very good question. We see IoTaho and Happiest Minds as a great mutual fit. As Suresh has said, Happiest Minds are a very agile organization. I think that's one of the key things that attracts their customers. And IoTaho is all about automation. We're using machine learning algorithms to make data discovery, data cataloging, understanding data redundancy much easier, and we're enabling customers and partners to do it much more quickly. So when you combine our emphasis on automation with the emphasis on agility that Happiest Minds have, that's a really nice combination. Works very well together, very powerful. I think the other things that are key are both businesses, as Suresh has said, are really innovative, digital native type companies, very focused on newer technologies, the cloud, et cetera. And then finally, I think they're both challenger brands, and Happiest Minds have a really positive, fresh, ethical approach to people and customers that really resonates with us at IoTaho too.
Great, thank you for that. Suresh, let's get into the whole notion of digital resilience. I want to sort of set it up with what I see, and maybe you can comment. I mean, prior to the pandemic, a lot of customers, they kind of equated disaster recovery with their business continuance or business resilience strategy, and that's changed almost overnight. How have you seen your clients respond to that, what I sometimes call the forced march to become a digital business? And maybe you could talk about some of the challenges that they've faced along the way.
Absolutely. So especially during this pandemic times, when you see Dave, customers have been having tough times managing their business. So Happiest Minds, being a digital resilient company, we were able to react much faster in the industry apart from the other services company. So one of the key things is the organizations trying to adopt onto the digital technologies, right? There has been a lot of data which has been to be managed by these customers, and there have been a lot of threats and risks which has been to be managed by the CIOs. So Happiest Minds Digital Resilient Technology, right? Where we bring in the data compliance as a service, we were able to manage the resilience much ahead of other competitors in the market. We were able to bring in our business continuity processes from day one, where we were able to deliver our services without any interruption to the services what we were delivering to our customers. So that is where the digital resilience with business continuity process enabled was very helpful for us to enable our customers continue their business without any interruptions during pandemics.
So, I mean, some of the challenges that customers tell me, obviously they had to figure out how to get laptops to remote workers and that whole remote, you know, work from home pivot, figure out how to secure the endpoints. And, you know, those were kind of, looking back, they were kind of table stakes. And it sounds like you've got digital business means a data business, putting data at the core, I like to say. But so I wonder if you could talk a little bit more about maybe the philosophy you have toward digital resilience and the specific approach you take with clients.
Absolutely, Dave. See, in any organization, data becomes the key. And thus, for the first step is to identify the critical data, right? So this is a six-step process what we follow in Happiest Minds. First of all, we take stock of the current state. Though the customers think that they have a clear visibility of their data, however, we do more of an assessment from an external point of view and see how critical their data is. Then we help the customers to strategize that, right? The most important thing is to identify the most important critical asset. Data being the most critical asset for any organization, identification of the data is a key for the customers. Then we help in building a viable operating model to ensure these identified critical assets are secured and monitored duly so that they are consumed well as protected from external threats. Then as a fourth step, we try to bring in awareness to the people. We train them at all levels in the organization. That is a key for people to understand the importance of the digital assets. And then as a fifth step, we work as a backup plan in terms of bringing in a very comprehensive and a holistic testing approach on people, process, as well as in technology to see how the organization can withstand during a crisis time. And finally, we do a continuous governance of these data, which is a key, right? It is not just a one-step process. We set up the environment, we do the initial analysis and set up the strategy and continuously govern these data to ensure that they are not only managed well, secured, as well as they also have to meet the compliance requirements of the organizations, right? That is where we help organizations to secure and meet the regulations of the organizations as per the privacy laws. So this is a constant process. It's not a one-time effort. We do a constant process because every organization goes towards their digital journey and they have to face all these as part of the evolving environment on digital journey. And that's where they should be kept ready in terms of recovering, rebounding, and moving forward if things go wrong.
So let's stick on that for a minute, and then I want to bring Youssef into the conversation. So you mentioned compliance and governance. When you're a digital business, you're a data business. So that brings up issues, data sovereignty, there's governance, there's compliance, there's things like right to be forgotten, there's data privacy, so many things. These were often kind of afterthoughts for businesses, that bolted on, if you will. I know a lot of executives are very much concerned these are built in. And it's not a one-shot deal. So do you have solutions around compliance and governance? Can you deliver that as a service? Maybe you could talk about some of the specifics there.
So we have offered multiple services to our customers on digital resilience. And one of the key services is the data compliance as a service. Here, we help organizations to map the key data against the data compliance requirements. Some of the features includes in terms of the continuous discovery of data, right? Because organizations keep adding on data when they move more digital, and helping in understanding the actual data in terms of the residence of the data. It could be in heterogeneous data sources, it could be on databases, or it could be even on the data lakes, or it could be even on on-premise or on the cloud environment. So identifying the data across the various heterogeneous environment is a very key feature of our solution. Once we identify and classify this sensitive data, the data privacy regulations and the prevailing laws have to be mapped based on the business rules. So we define those rules and help map those data so that organizations know how critical their digital assets are. Then we work on a continuous monitoring of data for anomalies, because that's one of the key features of the solution, which needs to be implemented on the day-to-day operational basis. So we help in monitoring those anomalies of data for data quality management on an ongoing basis. And finally, we also bring in the automated data governance, where we can manage the sensitive data policies and their data relationships in terms of mapping and manage their business rules. And we drive remediations to and also suggest appropriate actions to the customers to take on those specific data sets.
Great, thank you. Youssef, thanks for being patient. I want to bring in Io Tahoe to the discussion and understand where your customers and Happiest Minds can leverage your data automation capability that you and I have talked about in the past. And I mean, it'd be great if you had an example as well, but maybe you could pick it up from there.
Sure. I mean, at a high level, as Suresh has articulated really, Io Tahoe delivers business agility. So that's by accelerating the time to operationalize data, automating, putting in place controls, and ultimately helping put in place digital resilience. I mean, if we step back a little bit in time, traditional resilience in relation to data often meant manually making multiple copies of the same data. So you'd have a DBA, they would copy the data to various different places, and then business users would access it in those functional silos. And of course, what happened was you ended up with lots of different copies of the same data around the enterprise. Very inefficient, and of course, ultimately increases your risk profile, your risk of a data breach. It's very hard to know where everything is. And I really like that expression you used, David, the idea of the forced march to digital. So with enterprises that are going on this forced march, what they're finding is they don't have a single version of the truth. And almost nobody has an accurate view of where their critical data is. Then you have containers. And with containers, that enables a big leap forward. So you can break applications down into microservices. Updates are available via APIs. And so you don't have the same need to build and to manage multiple copies of the data. So you have an opportunity to just have a single version of the truth. Then your challenge is, how do you deal with these large legacy data estates that Suresh has been referring to, where you have to consolidate? And that's really where Io Tahoe comes in. We massively accelerate that process of putting this single version of the truth into place. So by automatically discovering the data, discovering what's duplicate, what's redundant, that means you can consolidate it down to a single trusted version much more quickly. We've seen many customers who've tried to do this manually, and it's literally taken years using manual methods to cover even a small percentage of their IT estate. With Io Tahoe, you can do it really very quickly, and you can have tangible results within weeks and months. And then you can apply controls to the data based on context. So who's the user? What's the content? What's the use case? Things like data quality validations or access permissions. And then once you've done that, your applications and your enterprise are much more secure, much more resilient as a result. You've got to do these things whilst retaining agility, though. So coming full circle, this is where the partnership with Happiest Minds really comes in as well. You've got to be agile. You've got to have controls. And you've got to drive towards the business outcomes. And it's doing those three things together that really deliver for the customer.
Thank you, Youssef. I mean, you and I, in previous episodes, we've looked in detail at the business case. You were just talking about the manual labor involved. We know that you can't scale, but also there's that compression of time to get to the next step in terms of ultimately getting to the outcome. And we've talked to a number of customers in theCUBE, and the conclusion is it's really consistent that if you can accelerate the time to value, that's the key driver, reducing complexity, automating and getting to insights faster. That's where you see telephone numbers in terms of business impact. So my question is, where should customers start? I mean, how can they take advantage of some of these opportunities that we've discussed today?
Well, we've tried to make that easy for customers. So with iOTAHO and Happiest Minds, you can very quickly do what we call a data health check. And this is a 2 to 3 week process to really quickly start to understand and deliver value from your data. So iOTAHO deploys into the customer environment. Data doesn't go anywhere. We would look at a few data sources and a sample of data, and we can very rapidly demonstrate how data discovery, data cataloging, and understanding duplicate data and redundant data can be done using machine learning, and how those problems can be solved. And so what we tend to find is that we can very quickly, as I say, in a matter of a few weeks, show a customer how they can get to a more resilient outcome, and then how they can scale that up, take it into production, and then really understand their data estate better and build resilience into the enterprise.
Excellent. There you have it. We'll leave it right there, guys. Great conversation. Thanks so much for coming in the program. Best of luck to you and the partnership. Be well.
Thank you, David. Suresh.
Thank you, Lisa.
And thank you for watching, everybody. This is Dave Vellante for theCUBE in our ongoing series on data automation with iOTAHO.